again, this is lots of papers. We just completed our two workshops, and it's a bit of a curve review, so we kind of mix a few different steps using height as a kind of dimension in our Tango. So we started our beginner class with a very, very kind of simple way to lead a side step followed by a channel weight. We're going to go up on our toes. One and two, and I can repeat the other side here. One and two, three and four. Of course, I can repeat more than one shot weight, and so on and so forth. We then have a look in our next class at ways of going up again and what effects it has, and especially when I'm going back, it's again a way to, with the dissociation, indicate to my partner I won't have to change her weight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Now, the little tip for this, of course, is to stay up on your toes. If you put your feet down, your partner is going to feel a bit confused because she doesn't feel the energy from you anymore. So, this is really important to actually stay up. And use a bit of association. I contract my core so that I really kind of pass the information to my partner. We also had a look at this little sequence, which has a bit of contrast. I'm going to get into Americana. Somehow, doesn't matter how. And then I'm going to go forward and immediately project the leg and indicate my partner. I wanted to do the same to indicate an accent in the song. And then very slowly, I'm going to make her rotate with the arm raise. She's changing front, now she's facing this, doing my legs. And I'm going to send her gently forward. And I catch this moment when she's ready to cross here. So of course, the important point to remember is that the timing of course has to go exactly when the feet are just kind of brushing against each other or her. And we then had a look at the last step, which was a bit of a bend, which is going back with my right, tilting the axis to make her cross a leg to the back. And I'm going to make a channel weight in this way.
El corazón me daría. Mm-hmm.